Welcome to this presentation on writing decision tables. Previously, we have introduced decision tables and covered simplifying and completeness check in their own videos. Now we will cover how to write a decision table using a set of 5 instructions. List the conditions, list the actions, add the rules, simplify and check the table, and add an else rule. We will use a simple example to show how a decision table should be written. Imagine you are defining the business rules for a cash point machine or ATM. You want the machine to only dispense money if the person enters the correct PIN number and has enough money or credit for their account. So how do we go about writing or drawing up a decision table? The first thing is to list your conditions. In theory, it is possible to list your conditions in any order, but in practice, it is better to list your conditions in a logical order, as this can speed up the evaluation and processing of the decision table. In our example, we have the conditions: correct PIN entered, bank withdrawal is less than the bank balance, and credit available is yes. If the PIN was checked after the other conditions, we could be wasting time in that those tests are not relevant unless the PIN is correct. Also, if there is sufficient funds in the bank to make the withdrawal, then there is no need to test credit availability. The next thing is to list the actions we want performed in the correct order. So if you want something actioned before another thing, then it has to be higher in the list. For example, our actions are to display an appropriate error message, re-enter a PIN and check it, dispense the money from the ATM, and repeat the decision table. For a particular rule, if the repeat is actioned before the other actions, then what follows cannot be performed. The third instruction in writing decision tables is to fill out the table entries one rule at a time by evaluating the conditions and associated actions. In practice, and with more experience, you may simplify the rules as you write them. In our example table, we will assume the following are true. The PIN is correct, and there are sufficient funds in the bank to make a cash withdrawal. The resulting rule is correct PIN, yes. Bank withdrawal is less than bank balance, yes. Then it doesn't matter about having credit available or not. So we have a dash for not relevant. In essence, we are simplifying two rules into this one. Dot the actions except the one we want to perform for these conditions, which is to dispense the money. In our example, this is a call to the decision table routine, release bank withdrawal. For the next rule, the PIN must be correct, but there are insufficient funds in the bank. However, if credit is available, then money can be dispensed, giving the rule YNY... The third rule of the table, the PIN is correct, yes. There are insufficient funds, no. And no credit is available, no. So the action is to display an appropriate error message, X, and the other actions are not performed, hence dots. The next four rules of the table are when the PIN is incorrect, the N entry, in combination with YN of the other conditions. The associated actions are to display an appropriate error message, X, call the decision table routine, enter and check PIN, X, and repeat the table, X. How do we know this table is complete? That leads us to our next instruction in writing decision tables. Check the table and then simplify it. As you will have seen in the simplifying and completeness check videos, the table is complete. And in our example, the last four rules of the table have been simplified to the one rule. If you have not seen those videos, please use the link below. The final instruction is to add an else rule. This is good practice. The else rule acts as an exception handler, and the more complex your decision tables become, the more likely you won't have covered all the rules. So define an else rule to capture those cases. In our example, we have replaced the N rule for incorrect PIN with the else rule. I hope you've found this video useful. More videos like this are available at rapidgen.com/videos. Please let us know if you have any questions about writing decision tables or if we can help. Send us an email at info@rapidgen.com or use the options below to leave a message. Thank you for watching.